Hey, how are you? Today we're going to show you how to do a foam edge replacement on a speaker cone. And this is for an Infinity. This is a 10-inch speaker, but it's actually an 11-inch frame, so it's kind of an odd speaker used in several popular Infinity models from the 70s. So we want to show you how to replace the foam on that. We'll start by cleaning the material off, cleaning the gasket, cleaning the cone, and showing you the fitment of the new parts. If you have any questions as far as your Infinity model is concerned, you can reach out to us on our website, through our live chat, or through our text system, and we'll get back to you right away. We're really fast with replies on that, so we encourage you folks to jump online and get in touch with us if you're not sure of your particular model. This particular woofer here is used in the RSA, the RS IIa, IIb, IIIb, 3A. There's a couple of numbers on these that you'll see as well, depending on the production date. This one is a 490780. They also make one that's almost identical with a clear polycone. Same exact speaker, but the cone is clear. And that is a 902-2279. There's another one known as a 902-5079. And they're a 10-inch speaker, but they use the 11-inch frame like I mentioned, and the cone runs a little smaller than a 10-inch speaker. A typical 10-inch speaker has about a 7.5 to 7.625-inch cone, and this one runs about 7.25 to 7.375. So in that case, we have a particular edge that's made just for this surround kit, and when we ship them to you, they come in a box like this. Okay, so they're in a flat box, and I'll kind of show you what that looks like here when you get these in the mail from us and open them up. Slide them open here like this. You want to avoid cutting the front edge here. We don't want to cut the parts inside. Okay, so you'll notice that when you get the kit from us, everything's kind of pre-bagged. In some cases, the kits are not pre-bagged internally like this, but we want to show you one that is, because sometimes we'll get messages from customers that think there's only one surround in the package, when in fact there are two. When you take them out of the package and slide them apart, you'll see that they're thin, but there will be two in the package for you, as that's what you're buying, is a kit to fix two speakers in this case. So we have another bag here that comes with the instructions. We put a business card in there in case you need to contact us, glue and a small brush, and we typically don't use the brush for much, but if you like, some folks would rather use the brush to spread the glue versus use their fingertip to do that. It's a little bit cleaner for them. I prefer to do the fingertip method on it with the adhesive, is that's just kind of what I'm used to, and it gives me a little better feel for what's going on. But we have the brush in there if you need it. If you decide you don't want to use it, just, you know, set it aside, use it for something else, or you can toss it. But that does come in the kit for you. When we come back, we'll show you how to clean the frame and the gasket, and we'll get started on it for you. All right, so we're back, and we're going to do the repair on the Infinity RS Series 11-inch woofer here. And I don't know if I showed you in the prior video, but when you measure the woofer, it actually measures 11 inches. And what will happen is if you try to replace it with a just kind of an off-the-shelf 10-inch woofer, they'll work, but you have to re-drill the screw holes in the cabinet. They don't really fit as nice as these original Infinities. So we like to save these by replacing the surround versus replacing the woofer in this case. And that's why we're kind of going through all the trouble here to show you how that works. It's important to us to maintain the originality of these unique pieces, as they're pretty vintage now, and they sound really good. So in any case, we're going to remove the gasket first, and we'll do that. We'll just use a utility knife like this. I like to use a retractable blade knife. You've seen me use this in other videos. This is kind of my favorite. And we'll come in here and we'll just pick a point and start like this. And just kind of work all the way around. You kind of hear it cutting the glue there. All right, and we could just use the cone as kind of a catch-all for all the little bits and pieces at this point. It doesn't hurt anything. Remove some of these larger pieces from the cone and get them removed at this point. We'll clean all those up here in just a little bit. And you'll see the gasket starting to kind of loosen up a little bit on us here. It's not done all the way, so we'll come in from the side like this, and we'll run the blade straight down and cut the glue at the corners. This particular gasket is a two-piece foam gasket, and there's really not a decent replacement on the market for it, so we like to take them off and reuse them. There's nothing wrong with them. They're purely decorative. You don't really even need the gasket, but we like to have them on there because it makes the speaker look good, and it dresses the glue bond on the frame with the surround. So we'll take this off and clean it. You'll see we still have some, I'll set the speaker kind of out of the way here. You'll see there's still some residue on the back of the gasket here, And we don't have to get all of that off, but we want to get most of that off. So we'll take a blade and just kind of lightly scrape it like this. And when it's dry, it'll come up fairly easily for you. And this is just kind of a labor of love. You just kind of have to work this and take your time with it. There's no real right or wrong way to do this part of it. It's whatever works for you. You take a little bit of rubbing alcohol or lacquer thinner and use an old rag that you don't care much about because you'll throw it away when you're done. If you dampen a little bit of this on there, it kind of helps break it down, as you can see, so that you can remove what's left of the residue there. And we'll kind of work at this for a minute or two here until that's cleaned up completely. And then we'll clean our work surface here as well to keep the top of the gasket clean. Again, no right or wrong rules for this. You'll see most of that is cleaned up. I'm going to set this aside for just a minute and we'll cap that. And we'll come in here when it's wet and you'll see that most of that will start to lift up. We're getting that right on the blade here. All right, that's about all you need to worry with on this. You take a little piece of paper towel and keep your blade clean. All right, like that. Try to get out of the camera's way there so you can see kind of what you're doing. There we go. All right, and you see the residue coming up on your blade there. There'll be a little bit of glue left over on the inside. Sometimes we'll kind of come in and cut that off like this, or you can just kind of peel that off in pieces. This is kind of the dirty part of the job. We have most of it there, as you can see from the front. We're in pretty good shape. I'll work on cleaning that just a little bit more. We'll clean up our work surface area, and then when we come back, we'll do the frame, and we'll do the cone, and then we can get rolling with installing the new surround. All right, we're back, and we cleaned the gasket up in the last segment for you, as we showed. You'll see it's kind of a two-piece thing here that's just glued back on the frame when we're done. And that's all you need to do on that is get all the old residue off the back of it and set it aside. You'll be reinstalling that when you're done with the repair. And now we'll concentrate on cleaning the frame and the cone. All right, once that's done, we can go ahead and start with the glue up on the surrounds and we'll be ready to roll. So first thing I like to do on this is we have the utility blade here. You can also use a chisel if you want to kind of do some scraping this way, but be super careful. You don't want to slip off and actually gouge the cone. So I prefer really to stick with the blade and do it slow and steady, and that's usually the best way to go. So the first thing we'll do is we'll come in here like this at an angle with the blade and just kind of cut this inner glue and foam off of the frame like this. Okay, and you'll see the glue's kind of stringy. Again, you can throw it right in the inside of the cone if you'd like. All this will end up in the trash when you're done. It doesn't hurt anything. And you'll see that leaves kind of a shiny mark there, and that shows that you've gotten that all the way around the frame there, and that's what you want. All right, so we'll come in here like this, and we'll do just a scrape and peel is what we're kind of doing here. So just work slowly. We have customers tell us they'll get Dremel tools out and this and that and the other and sanding discs, and that's all fine. All of that works. None of it's required. But if that's what you'd like to do, then that's, of course, that's fine. But the main thing is to just get all this old foam and residue cleaned off the frame. And because it's deteriorated, it comes off fairly easily. The glue will be a little sticky, and that's where you get a little bit of a mess going. You just have to take your time and kind of pick at it and poke at it and get it wrapped up. Okay. So you can see I've kind of gone around one time with this already. I'll just kind of keep going. It doesn't need to be down to bare metal. You don't need to scrape the paint off the frame, but you want to remove all the old dry foam and glue to a nice smooth surface for the new surround. All right. That gives you an idea of what that looks like when it's done. And again, you can go a little further with it than that if you'd like. We'll probably do a little touch-up on it before we come back on the camera to show you the glue-up. But that gives you the general idea of what's going on there. And then the same thing with the cone. Just pick off these big pieces, what's left on them. You'll notice I just kind of hold the cone with one hand to steady it. The cone is made of plastic or a polypropylene, so in this case it's pretty durable. You can't really hurt it, so just pay attention to what you're doing there. You see how I'm kind of just pinching my fingers together and pulling the old dried foam right along the edge, right off the cone. So now we have a layer of foam left on the cone here, and we can just kind of hold the cone up with one hand and take the blade with the other. Okay. You see what's going on there? Just kind of shaving that off of there. We're not cutting the cone. We're just scraping the surround off of the cone. Okay. Yours may be a little gummier than that, and that's fine. If that's the case, just do the best you can. Then we'll come back in later with a damp cloth with some rubbing alcohol, and we'll clean that all up. You see what we got here? A little bit of adhesive on the bottom. We don't want to scrape or cut the visible part of the cone there. We're just working on the edge where the surround was attached. So it takes kind of a steady hand and pay attention to what you're doing there. All right, you'll be fine. Don't be nervous to touch or handle the cone. You're not hurting anything there. It's more durable than you think. Okay, so I'm going to take a little bit of rubbing alcohol now, and we'll kind of rub the outer edge of the cone just to get any leftover residue off of the surround area there where it attaches. And you'll see that cleans up rather nicely. All right, now we have a bunch of residue in the middle of the cone. I'm gonna go ahead and dump that in the trash. Don't need that in there anymore. All right, so that's what we're left with there. If you have an old paintbrush or something laying around, you wanna get the dust out of the cone, you can. All right, you'll see it's just kind of bouncing around in there, and that's fine. Okay, and then I'm gonna take another run with the rubbing alcohol in a clean section of the rag here. Kind of clean that up. And you can run that all the way down the cone if you'd like, all the way down into the center dust cap area there. You can't hurt anything. It evaporates off, and it takes a lot of that extra residue and dirt off of there at the same time. So it gives you a nice clean surface to work with. All right. So for a quick run to show you how it works, that's pretty much where you're at and what you're after. And when we come back, we'll do a little more touch up on this, but when we come back, we'll show you how to start dry fitting the part and showing you how everything glues together, and we'll get it rolling. All right, so we're back. We did a little further cleanup on this, like we mentioned in the last segment, to show you how to kind of prep the speaker. And now we're gonna go ahead and kind of do the hard part. We're gonna glue it up. We're gonna first attach the surround to the cone. We'll let that dry for an hour or two, depending on the humidity and your climate. You may find that it takes a little bit longer or a little bit less. We'd like to give it an hour minimum between steps. So we'll glue the new surround to the cone, and then we'll glue it to the frame, and then we'll set the centering of the coil, and then we'll do the gasket, and we'll be good. And one thing of note on this particular unit is when you see the surround fitment here, there's going to be a little gap between the surround and the frame. That's normal. The surround is not intended to go edge to edge on the frame, and that's true pretty much with any speaker. There's supposed to be a gap there. On some models, it's a little larger than others. Sometimes it may be as high as a quarter inch. In this case, it's fairly tight. It's just a couple of millimeters there, as you can see, and it fits in the frame just like you see, all right? You can set it off to the side, and then there's more of a gap on one side, but it's your job to kind of center it visually when you do the gluing. The key really is gonna be when you glue it to the cone. Then everything else will just kind of line up properly for you. And you'll notice too, when you lay this around here when you're just kind of doing your dry fit, you'll see how this works. The cone and surround aren't really touching. There's a gap there, okay? That's also normal. It's not going to touch that until you make that happen. You're going to need to lift the cone a little bit from behind, as I'm doing here with my hands, and then you'll see it lays down on there fairly nice, but there's still a little bit of a gap there because the angle of the surround is a little bit flared up compared to what the cone is, so it's your job when you glue this to kind of bring that down and attach to that angle. The surround itself may appear to not have the same angle, but that's because it's designed to fit different angle cones, all right? And in this case, you'll see a little bit of a gap there. So when we glue that, we're gonna work that out, and the glue is fast enough in its set that you can do that without clamping or without any other type of weights to make that happen, all right? So what I'll do is we'll go ahead and just flip this upside down. We're gonna apply the glue to the inside of the surround here and smooth that out. Then we're gonna flip the surround over, lift the cone up, and center everything, and then as we're working that, it'll start to dry and to cure, and then we'll let it dry for an hour or two, and then we'll come back and then we'll do the outside. So just wanted to give you some visuals on that. Set the surround, in this case, upside down, and we're going to apply the glue right to this outside edge like this. Okay, so you'll see us do that here. The camera will kind of show you that as they angle in for you. So we'll remove the cap from the glue. Keep a clean rag handy, okay, for you on this, so that you can wipe up any excess and try to keep the job as clean as possible. If you get a little bit of glue on the cone, don't worry about it. You can come back and clean that up later, all right? And we want to kind of squeeze the glue from the back of the cone as best you can. That's easier said than done if you're not used to working with these metal tube adhesives, but in this case, you want to just really take your time. You might want to practice on a little scrap of paper first before you start doing the attachment as I'm showing here now, just so you can get a feel for how fast it comes out and what that's like, okay? So you'll see I placed an eighth of an inch bead right in the center of the surround, capped the glue, put the glue back off to the side, and then I'm just using my fingertip here to lightly spread the adhesive. Okay, hopefully the camera can kind of pick that up a little bit. You'll see it kind of gets wetted all the way around, all right? And while it's still wet, we're gonna go ahead and lift it, and we're just gonna center it visually in the frame. Again, don't worry about things here. It doesn't have to be perfect. You don't need a micrometer for this. It isn't about all that. You just wanna get it centered as best as you can, all right? Now I'm gonna lift the cone up, and I'm gonna kinda prop it to the side and hold it with one hand. That's what I'm doing here, so that I can work the surround down with my other hand. I'm not gonna move this hand. I'm gonna keep it here the entire time while I'm working this. And you can move it back and forth a little bit if you need to as this starts to set up, all right? And we're just kind of going around and pressing it down into the cement as the cement dries around the cone. Okay, again, I'm not taking this hand out of play. I'm just leaving it there. Some folks like to take a couple wadded up paper towels and put them behind the cone. That's fine. I kind of prefer to do it this way. You do it however you like. There's not an exact right or wrong answer for that. Just do what's comfortable for you. All right, so you'll see I'm just kind of holding this up with one hand and just working with the other. I've got it angled so the camera can see better. Normally we're just working it kind of like this, looking straight down on it. But in this case, I'm turning it for your benefit so you can see exactly what we're doing here. All right, and I'm kind of bringing this in and working the surround down onto the cone. You see that angle has closed up. There's no more gap. The gap you may have been worried about at the beginning when you dry fitted and saw that is gone. And that's the intention, okay? And there's no clamping required. You see the adhesive is aggressive enough to hold these parts together within a few moments of application, but it still gives you some time to move it around if you need to. If you see where you're off or it's coming off the cone this way and you need to move it a little this way, you can do that. We're gonna center the voice coil later, so in this case, just getting it centered on the cone visually is the most important thing, all right? So we're kind of working this down and around. Once it starts to set, you can just kind of pull your finger around. You can use the thumb, use your forefinger, use your middle finger, use your pinky finger, whatever you like, use your ring finger, doesn't really matter, all right? So in this case, you see what's going on here. We've pretty much got it, all right? We're giving it a little bit more time. We're gonna continue to work with it until it's where we want it to be, and we know it's not gonna lift or come up any further. And it's really, this is all happening in real time. So you get a couple of minutes to do this, and again, if you need to, you can kind of still pull it and move it with a little bit of force if necessary, all right? But you see what we've got going on here? That's what you want, okay? That's what you want right there. And again, right here, you see I got a little bit of glue on the cone. That's okay, we'll go back and clean that up later. Little Q-tip, A little rubbing alcohol will clean that up nicely for us when we're done. So don't concern yourself with that. It's not going to be perfect right off Jump Street. You're going to maybe have a little bit of that, and that's okay. You can come back later and take care of that if you like. Okay, so again, we're just going to continue to work this around like this. As you can see, this is where you need to be with this. We're going to let this dry up for an hour or two. When we come back, we'll show you the gluing to the frame. We'll install the gasket. We'll center the coil. And when we center the coils on these, we do them by hand, and that's as accurate as any other method out there. This speaker will be ready to go back into the cabinet for service after all of that is complete. So we'll take a pause now, let this dry up, and we'll come back and finish it up for you. All right, we're back. We let the surround dry to the cone for, in this case, it's about an hour or so. It dried pretty quick for us. So we're going to go ahead and do the setup to the frame. And you'll see now that we have good attachment point here all the way around the cone, we can lift the surround and it's staying attached properly to the cone without any issues. So we're good. And we'll apply the glue right here along the bottom of the frame rail. Like this, the surround will kind of set back in place. To center the speaker, once the surround is installed on the top of the cone or on the cone like you see here, the centering pretty much takes care of itself. The support is in place. The spider beneath the cone is the primary suspension. This is the secondary suspension. And as you can see, just a simple press down in the center of the cone pretty much centers the mechanism. We'll go ahead and apply the glue and we'll show you that in a little more detail, but that's the general idea of it. When we're done, we'll place the gasket sections back on top. We have the two pieces that go in like this, and we'll let it set up for another hour or so, and we'll be good for testing, and then it can go back into the cabinet and be put back into service. So first thing we'll do here is we'll just start with the glue again. We'll remove the tip. We want to keep the cap or the tip on the glue as long as possible so the glue doesn't coagulate on you there at the end. So we'll go ahead and run a little bead here. You see what I'm doing? I'm just kind of holding the tube in place, and then I'm spinning the speaker with the other hand. One time around is all it takes, about an eighth of an inch. Wipe the tip, replace the cap, and now we have adhesive underneath the surround all the way around, as you can see. All right, so I like to just kind of lift the cone assembly, and you can kind of move it side to side like this. If you turn it 90 degrees, you can kind of move it side to side like that. So just think of an axis through the middle of this, front, back, north, north, south, west, east, front, back, side, side, whatever works for you is fine. And then we'll come ahead and just kind of press down like this in the center, and we'll start to center the mechanism here. The adhesive is going to start to kind of grab around the outer edge of the frame like this. I'm going to run my thumb around this just to kind of press it into the adhesive. So now I know I have a good wet surface underneath the surround all the way around. And you'll see that you can kind of push it off center like this, either way. Or you can just, again, right in the center like this, it'll start to grab. Once the surround starts to kind of pull down into the cement, then we'll go ahead and try it again. We'll just kind of keep checking our work and kind of staying on top of this. We do a little bit of babysitting on this right now while this is drying, while you're working with it, okay? And once it's centered as it can be. There's not going to be really off one side or the other. If it's off one side or the other, it's going to have, the coil's going to scrape and you're going to feel the friction there. So as long as you keep kind of working this as you're going along, you're going to be fine with that. A lot of folks get a little overly concerned with that, and it's really not as much of a worry as you may think it is. All right. Trying and checking it again. And you can see now it's starting to grab on the outside of the frame. I can give it a little pressure. You see my hands are underneath equally on both sides. I'm lifting it as well. So the speaker, of course, moves back and forth in its travel during playback. And we want to make sure that not only the downstroke, but the upstroke is clean as well. So we're going to just keep checking it. The surround kind of keeps lifting from the outer edge as we do so, and that's fine. Don't worry with that so much. It's starting to kind of grab now. And when we get to this point, we want to kind of work it again. I'm kind of lifting from both sides, or lifting from the back of the cone in four different sections here with my hands, as you can see. I'll do two like this. We'll turn it. We'll do two like this. Same thing on the downstroke like this. And again, we're just kind of working it here, getting a feel for everything. In this case, we'll give it just a little light tap on the four quadrants and make sure that it's not rubbing. If it's rubbing here a little bit, just move it slightly this way. If It's rubbing here a little bit, move it slightly this way, and you have room to do that. The surround is still pliable, the adhesive is not set yet, all right? In this case, we're pretty golden. We shouldn't have to really do any more adjustments at this point. You see the surround is still lifting a little bit on the frame. We're going to continue to kind of work that a little bit. And in this case, we're in good shape. It feels great. It's really centered nice. If we need to move it, again, we still can. You can just do a little pull, little push, little tuck, whatever you need to do there to get it where you want it to be. All right. And we're liking this. This is great. Okay, so at this point, it'll continue to dry, but we can go ahead and set the gasket. You can let this dry and come back and do the gasket later, or you can do it now. And for just the speed and for the purposes of the video, we're going to go ahead and do that now for you. We're going to uncap our adhesive once again. We're going to apply another bead right along the landing here on the frame, just like that. Wipe the glue. Replace the cap, take a look, there's where you want to be. And the gasket's two pieces. You can either set your seams on the gasket with the holes, or you can set it straight across. On this particular speaker, because the lead wires are here and the way they're mounted in the frame like this, I like to set the seams right where my fingers are here so you can see that. So we'll go ahead and place the first gasket in and set it in like this. And I'm just eyeballing this distance here to make sure this is about right. It doesn't have to be perfect, but you want to get it as straight as you can so it looks nice when everything's back together. We'll do this one as well. Same thing. All right, you see what we've got going there. All right, the seams are right where the fingers are here. So once this is mounted in the cabinet, they'll look nice and straight for you like that. So it looks like you were kind of paying attention, which is what you are. That's what you're doing. All right, so we'll do that. The speaker's pretty much done for our purposes. I'm going to go ahead and flip the speaker over. We'll let the weight of the speaker hold the gasket in place, and then we'll let that dry for about an hour. We'll come back and test it. After that, we'll come back and test, and we'll be good to go, and we can reinstall it back into the cabinet. Okay, so we're back. We had this sitting like this here for the last hour or so, and she's ready to go. Everything's done on it. All the adhesive is dry, looks good. The action on it is nice, centered up beautifully for us, and we're pretty much good to go. As an optional thing, you could test this out on a signal generator. We do have one here at the shop that we use for doing repair, and you might not have that at home, and that's okay. You could just use an audio signal, or if you're comfortable with everything, you just place it back into the cabinet and you're good to go. But you'll notice when you look real close at the tabs here, they're the same size on this particular woofer. In some cases, they're different sizes. Large tab would indicate positive, a smaller tab would indicate the negative connection, or sometimes they're color-coded. In this case, they've done a red dot over here. That's your positive side. Does not matter which wire you go to, they are identical. Same thing on this side. This automatically, of course, will be your negative connection. If you connect them out of phase, it won't hurt the speaker, but it will reduce its bass performance. So if you hook it up and it doesn't sound right to you, it sounds thin, at that point you might want to remove it, swap the wires, and you might just have the wire connection out of phase. So in this case, we have the positive here, negative here, so we'll connect with our signal generator. We just have these little alligator clips, and this is already turned on over here. It's kind of out of the screen, you can't see it. So we'll come in like this, and we'll show you kind of what that looks like. So we'll connect that there. All right, so there we go. Okay, and we're just running a tone here around 25 hertz through this right now. Minimum voltage. We don't want to go nuts on this. You don't want to kill it. You don't want to pound on it. You just want it to exercise a little bit like this. Once it's back in the cabinet and it's got its air seal back behind it again and the cabinet pressure behind it, the cone will behave normally. In free air, it's going to move a lot more than it would once it's mounted and in service in your system. Okay, so we have an adjustment on here where we can run a few frequencies through this. Like this. Okay, you'll see that. And that's pretty much it. That just gives you a quick test to let you know everything's working properly with the speaker. And in this case, we are good to go. This is one of several thousand different kits that we sell here at the shop. If you have any questions, you can reach out to us through our website, which is simplyspeakers.com. We have live chat, we have text, and we are fast on replies on those. pretty much throughout the week, even after hours, and in many cases we'll get back to you a lot quicker than you might think. So don't be afraid to use those technologies. That's what they're there for, and those have really worked out well for us to get customers with the correct part numbers. In some cases, if we're not sure what you have, we may ask you for a photo. You can send that to us through the live chat or the text, and then once we see what you have, we can get you the information that you need. So don't be afraid to reach out to us that way, and we're glad to help you out. Thanks. All right, so we're finished up here. Earlier in the video, we showed you all the setups, the glues, the final setup, as well as we ran it on the tone generator for you just to kind of show what that is. That's totally optional. You don't need to worry with that at home. In most cases, you won't have that type of equipment, and that's okay. So we want to just kind of go over everything with you one more time. We did the cleaning. We did the gluing of the surround. This is for the Infinity RS Series Woofer. There are many others in this case that we sell parts for. We have kits literally for thousands of different speakers and brands. And what we want to emphasize to you is that maybe you get on our website, you're not sure what you're looking for, you don't know what your model or brand is. If you reach out to us through our live chat or through our text on the website, we may ask you for a photo and we'll respond to you right away. We'll send you links to what you need. We can send you pictures. You can send photos to us. We can draw on those photos electronically and then ask you for certain things. So don't be intimidated by this. It's pretty straightforward stuff, and we're good at it. We know what you need, but you need to reach out to us and let us know if you don't see it on the website immediately. Try that search bar first on the site. Anything beyond that, hit us up at simplyspeakers.com. Just click the contact us link, and we'll get back to you right away and make it happen. Thanks so much.